redesigned every single Miraculous holder, from Miraculous Ladybug, Tales of Ladybug, and Cat Noir. It was awful. It took forever, but I did it. Let's not hold anything back. Let's just jump right into the video, because this is just one long speed paint video where I'm just going to talk about all the designs I made, the process behind designing them, my thoughts behind designing them, and I want to hear what you guys think of my designs. I'll mention everything that went down on TikTok while I was making those designs, because there was lots of feedback that you guys gave. Have not updated any of my designs since you guys gave me that feedback, but I will be mentioning it in the video. For those who don't know me, hello, my name is Gail. I'm an artist, illustrator, and graphic designer, and I hate Miraculous Ladybug. So you're probably wondering, why am I here? Why am I doing this? I used to like Miraculous Ladybug when I was 13. I'm not a fan of the show anymore. I really hate the show. However, I did a TikTok series breaking down all of the designs for all of the heroes and all of the villains. People really liked it and wanted me to make my own designs. So I did. And here we are today. It's been a year since I started my Miraculous series, and I have finally finished it 1 year later. So yeah, this has been a long time coming. I just wanted to put everything all together in one place so people could see what I made and what I did. Just a note, yeah, there will be tracing in this video. This whole thing is just about doing character designs. It's not about anatomy. It's not about being perfect. So yes, I do trace some reference photos in there. Be mad if you want. With that little disclaimer out of the way, let's just jump right into the speed paint, with the very first one being the peacock design.
Ah, shit. Here we go again.
So the very first one I did was the peacock, and you may be wondering why the peacock was my first choice, and it's because that is my favorite of the Miraculouses. It always has been, and even though I don't like the show, if I had to choose a favorite out of the Miraculouses, it would be that one. Of course, I was watching the show before they revealed that it was just basically a rip-off version of the Butterfly Miraculous, so I don't like its power set, but I stuck with it anyway. This one is where I established the rules for this whole design series, as it was the first one, and I decided that essentially I would have a strict set of rules that I would follow basically almost all the time. The Kwami would be the main source of the color palette, so any color palette I would make for each design had to derive from the colors of the Kwami. The only exception is when the color palette just does not work under any circumstances. It is an unworkable palette. That is when I allow an exception and I change the colors. Additionally, I would make a more masculine oriented design and a more feminine oriented design. While I do believe that clothes can be worn by anyone, it is just traditional to make there be two different versions of an outfit, since we can and have seen people of different genders wearing these designs in the show, so I figured it was my duty to make sure I had at least two of each design. Now for this one, the one for the guy is actually inspired by a design that I made back when I was a fan of the show when I was really young, 13 or 14 years old. It was very musketeer oriented and theatrical, and I decided I really wanted to keep that look with some added elements. There are pieces of Argos's design that I think are quite beautiful, and I really like them. So there are a few pieces of his design incorporated into this one, including a musketeer hat, a very theatrical looking coat, and homage to peacock feathers across the coat design. One thing that people suggested was that I change the color of all the little peacock feathers on the pants to be light blue, or maybe dark blue, or just a lighter shade of the purple that I used for the pants, because it feels like they're a little too much at the moment, and I am inclined to agree, and I think that is something that I would change if I were going back and editing these. As for the female one, I really wanted this one to come off as a lot more graceful and elegant, with some figure skating vibes to it. I wanted something that was sheer and see-through, but looked like it could glide around very elegantly, like real peacocks do, so that was the vibe for this one. Peacocks are also capable of spreading their feathers to form a very wide arc behind them. It looks very elegant and pretty, and I think it was reminiscent of a collar on various outfits that you see in Victorian times, so I wanted both of these designs to have collars on them as well. Finally, you can see in the more feminine design that I did make sure that I also included the homage to the feathers like I did in the male design. This is a consistent little stylistic thing that I just kept throughout both designs, and then as a rule, I decided that I would always add some action poses just so you guys could see the designs in action, how they would look if they were actually moving, if someone was actually wearing them and doing superhero stuff in them. This gives you a good idea of how they would work, it lets you see how they flow, and if they look good when they're not just standing there, because something can look great when it's just standing still, but you gotta know if it looks good while you're moving too. I want these to feel like they could actually exist, so showing them in action is really, really important. Another rule that I made was that I would keep the same tool or accessory or device that the Miraculous Miraculous holders use in the show, unless the device or tool itself is just really stupid or I feel like it just doesn't work. For example, you'll see that I later on changed the dog's tool entirely to something else, but here you can see that I keep the fan for the peacock, and there will be some variations depending on which design we're looking at, but most of them keep their original tools.
This right here is my favorite thing ever in the history of forever. I think about this every day. I think about this all night long. I stay awake, not sleeping, because I'm thinking about this.
So if you happen to watch my video where I broke down all of the designs for all of the heroes, you would know that I had essentially nothing but praise for Adrian's Mr. Bug design, aside from the name being really goofy. My favorite thing about that design is how well it utilizes black, as well as utilizing the natural armor look that bugs have to make him look like he has this really armored suit on, even though it's just a bodysuit. And I really wanted to play into that with my designs for the Ladybug. So I went with a very armored look. I gave her a very gray and black inspired outfit with red as more of an accent color, specifically because I feel like Marinette's Ladybug design, while easily iconic and a very memorable design, feels extremely overwhelming because it's so bright. So something that I really wanted to do was tone down the red a lot, tone down the spots a lot, and just make it look more like an actual armored suit, and of course, give her wings, because these are ladybugs we're talking about. They can fly. So I really, really wanted to give these bug characters wings so they could actually fly around. No need for a yo-yo anymore. They got wings. I don't know what I would change the tool to. I didn't think about it at the time, but I'm open to ideas. Maybe she could have some sort of luck-related power, since I think that's a lot more realistic than creation and creating anything, but whatever. Another thing I really wanted to experiment with this design was yellow ladybugs, because yellow ladybugs are real, they exist, they're really cool, and I think it would be really neat if we saw a yellow ladybug in the show. So I made a yellow variant of the design for both the girl and the guy. Alright, so for this one, I decided to only do one model. I didn't do a masculine versus feminine for this one. I went really, really androgynous with this one because I really like the Rena Rouge design as is. I feel like it's a pretty solid design. And I was like, okay, well, we haven't seen a guy use it yet. Why don't I just do something androgynous so we can meet halfway? So that's what I did. So I did take the idea of a kitsune mask, just not the actual full kitsune as a nine-tailed fox, and I used that as my main inspiration. And this idea of using these more theatrical masks and kitsune-style masks became a lasting trend for me as I did this series. It was kind of an idea that I hadn't seen anybody use before, using these theatrical masks as a way to hide your secret identity. Like, no one had ever done that before in any of the redesigns that I'd ever seen, so it was something I really wanted to try, and I wanted to go for a more mysterious look with this one, so there's a very long cape that takes up the image of a tail, sort of like how Rena Rouge's suit goes, but just a little bit different. There's more of an emphasis on brown in this one, there's a little bit more textures, and I tried to go to match the style of a northern red fox, because those are the colors of the fox Kwame. However, given the freedom to do so, I would have loved to have experimented around with different types of foxes, because there's all sorts of different types of foxes. There's Arctic foxes, foxes, gray foxes, silver foxes, there's a lot of different foxes out there. So it would have been fun to play around with some different types of foxes, but given that we were only given the standard traditional red fox, I had to stick with that. But I'm very happy with what I came up with, and I think it captures that mysterious vibe pretty dang well. I feel like I utilized the color palette pretty well, I like how the shoes look, I think it flows really well, so I'm proud of this one. Let me know what you all think of it.
Good God! It's hideous, but beautiful in an ugly way, but mostly hideous.
So I took the goat in a completely different direction than what the show wanted to do with the goat. I don't think they had a plan for what to do with the goat. I think they were just like, hey, we need to make every single background character in this show get a Miraculous at some point. Which one have we not used yet? Okay, goat. Nathaniel hasn't had one yet. Okay, goat. Let's give him goat. Make it create because he is artist. Like, come on, guys. You could do better than that. So my take on the goat was entirely different. And I thought the goat would have a much more direct frontal assault type of fighting style. It would be extremely powerful. They would have really powerful kicks. They would be a beast to deal with. They would be able to ram down stuff. Like, they would be a battering ram. They would be insane little psychopaths. So I have this really short character who's a little bit on the heavier side to be this hero, just because I felt that was fitting for the needs and the vision that I had for this particular one. They have a very thick leather vest on, some really nice cargo pants, and a big staff they can use for whacking things, some really heavy duty shoes, really big horns. They can deal a lot of damage here. They're also going to be really tolerable to weather. That's why they got this really nice looking furry jacket on. I feel like this one has a good weight to it. It feels very grounded, which is good because it's a goat. I had a great time while designing this one. It just matched the vibes that I was going for so well. I had a fun time with it. And then my second one is a little bit taller. This one has more of an outdoorsy vibe, a little bit less of a, like, I'm going to come ram you kind of vibe, but this one is definitely more like I'm able to climb up mountains and scale walls like a goat can. Still has the same idea going on with the cargo pants. They still have the exact same leather chest plate that's going on, but they have more of a parka look to them, not as intense horns. This one would be really, really good at traveling up mountains. They'd be really good at scaling walls. They'd still be really good at kicking, but I'm getting more of the vibes of this one is better for outdoorsy stuff and weather stuff. They'd be really good at camping. They'd be really good at knowing their way around the wilderness, stuff like that. I also went with a much more neutral color palette for this one. The goat just has black and white as its main color palette, and then some red when Nathaniel's wearing it because of his hair. But this one I decided to use more of the natural purples and warm grays within the goat's color palette, so I really utilized that purple just to give it a little bit of tone and texture to it. Just to add a little bit more than just straight up black and white, I added in some grays, and I think it adds a much needed sense of depth. I grew up with goats. They are insane little creatures. I love pygmy goats. I know the personality of those things like the back of my hand, so I felt that this was very fitting for doing the goats. And then of course I did some action poses just to display what I meant. So we have the little guy doing some kicks and we have the tall one who's running. I think they're pretty good. I'm pretty happy with the goats. Okay, I went for a more traditional vibe with this one, focusing on the shape of a snake and the body of a snake, and especially referencing the shape of the snake Kwame's head, because he has this really cool shape, and I thought that would make a really neat hat, especially using Embo from Clone Wars as my reference, because he has a very neat hat that functions very similarly. I also thought it would be interesting to play around with incorporating more armor into my designs, because that's something that I find to be very practical and very useful. So that's something that I have in the design. I really like the color palette. I desaturated it quite a bit, and I think that honestly really, really helped. And I kept this more traditional look with both designs. One of them has a slightly more kimono-esque look to them. The other one has more of a cape. Both of them have the diamond as an accent shape, which I think ties in real nicely with the general sharpness of the design. Both of them feel very unique and very sleek, and I'm very proud of both of them. I also started playing around with irregular face masks with this one, so I took a more Kakashi mask style approach, and I started using that quite a bit throughout my designs, because there's multiple ways you can hide your identity outside of just using a regular eye mask. So I really wanted to embrace that and play around with the more Kakashi style mask. You can see I messed around with different ways to portray snake scales, different ways to portray a snake's body. This one was a very fun experiment for me, especially since this is a color palette that I don't usually use, but I'm very proud of the results. I don't know which one of these sets of designs I would consider my favorite, but this is definitely like top three or top five for me, just because I'm very proud of it. I really like this one, and I think it comes from me really liking Vipirion's original design in the first place.
You don't want to be like this. This is disgusting. This is awful in every way. If I could kill it, I would, but I legally can't, but I've considered it.
So I actually went ahead and did two different versions of what I would do if I made a redesign for the butterfly. My very first one, which you're seeing here, is a redesign that is essentially an entire overhaul. This is completely brand new. So I knew I wanted to do something different than just the original Hawkmoth design, the original Hawkmoth colors, the original Kwame. I hate everything about it. There are no moths that are purple, first off. So I was looking up purple butterflies, and they do exist, and I found some real butterfly species that I used as a reference for this, because it's supposed to be a butterfly, Miraculous, not a moth. I know he's called Hawkmoth, and for some reason, it's a moth Kwame, but it's a butterfly Miraculous. It makes me so angry. It makes no sense. So I was like, I'm gonna make it be an actual butterfly, okay. So that's what I did, and I found a real butterfly. I took the colors from it, made that my color palette. I completely changed the powers. I completely changed the tool. It has a butterfly looking book inspired by the Wingology book from Tinkerbell Secret of the Wings, and I used Shinobu as my reference because I really like her coat. I think it's very beautiful. She has a very cute design, and I really wanted to use that as my reference for this. I felt this would be very airy. It looks very elegant, which is what I attribute butterflies to be. I also wanted to have a butterfly wing mask because that's just gorgeous. How could I not? Working with these colors was very fun. I had a really good time with the boots. I had a really fun time with the textures as well. And then I had had the idea of the Miraculous being this little chain earring that would hang off of the ear. I was so inspired with this one. I had such a good time. And then when I started working on the guy one, I was very inspired by Howl from Howl's Moving Castle, along with some other fairy-based characters and butterfly-based characters. So there's a little bit of Poof in here as well from Hunter Hunter, because he is literally just a character with butterfly wings. He's very theatrical. He's got a fit very similar to this, so similar vibes. I kept the clothing style very, very similar. Color palette is essentially the same, and I gave the guy a little bit larger and taller boots because I really like that butterfly shape and wanted to experiment with it a bit. Also has a butterfly style top, which is a real shirt, and I'm very proud of it. I think these colors are very soothing. I think they work very well for a butterfly hero. I think I just did a really good job with this one. I'm very, very proud of how it looks. I also like the hair shape that I came up with. It's very blocky and unique and fun. I think it gives him a really nice and unique silhouette. I really enjoy it. Though unfortunately, people are like, yeah, we really like this, but you need to make it a villain. So I did my other one where I went back and I took the original Hawk Moth colors and the original Kwame colors, and I made a Hawk Moth version, and I don't like it. I like the girl. I like the girl design I made, but I don't like the guy design I made. And a lot of you gave a lot of really good feedback, and I agree with most of it, so we're gonna shift over to talking about that next. Alright, so I think the concept of what I came up for with the guy was okay. I just don't think the execution was all that great. I knew I wanted to go for a really big dramatic collar and cape, but I think the real problem here with the design that I made is just that I added too much detail and there's not enough coherent shapes. There's too many large shapes happening at the bottom of the cape, which makes it look very distracting, and I was going for the look of Nuru's wings way too much. I really wanted to try to copy that, but I think it just looks very distracting. I also feel like the armor style look that I put on the torso isn't quite correct. It doesn't really fit the rest of the shape language of the design, and I'm just not really a fan of it, so I would definitely go back and change that. However, I do think the shape that I came up with for the boots works really well, and I do like that I kept the light purple as a subtle accent color, so there's definitely a lot that I would change to go back and fix this and redo it and make it look a lot better than what it currently looks like. So I'm open to more ideas and suggestions. You guys were very helpful at giving me feedback on this one, because I don't think it looks the best. It's definitely not one of my stronger ones, but on the other hand, the girl looks very good. I was very inspired with this one. I was going for a look similar to one of Ross Draw's characters. I took a hairstyle that's very close to one of his characters, and I gave her this very airy butterfly wing inspired cape, similar to my hero look, but a lot darker. This one's a lot more mysterious. I feel like the flare pants really help accent this cape look, and I think that this overall dark vibe is really good. I think that I use the circles correctly here, just as a very subtle accent color. This one just feels very dramatic and very elegant, and this is definitely the vibe that I wanted to go for with the guide that I just didn't really achieve. So if I were redesigning it, I would definitely pay closer attention to what I did right with this one girl's design, but I'm very proud of this. So we're in a 50-50 situation here. I really like the girl, but I don't really like the guy, and I'm open to hearing any other thoughts you may have on the guy, because that one needs some work.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached, head is matted black, got the bushes black to match.
Okay, the horse was probably the most awful experience that I've ever had, because I hate the horse Miraculous. It just should not exist. I hate it. It's awful. I have not liked any of the designs that I've ever seen for it. I don't like the one that Max has. I don't like any of the redesigns. I don't like that it's called a Pegasus, but you'd never actually see anything that's Pegasus related. So I could not come up with any sort of idea for anything that looked good for this design. I tried so many things, and so many people suggested so many things, and none of them ever looked good. There were people who suggested I look up this one superhero and using a mask similar to hers, but it was looking more like a gas mask than it was looking like a horse. Whenever I tried to use the color palette of the actual Kwame, it was giving cow vibes rather than horse vibes. It was not going good. And eventually I had to go yeehaw with it. I had to go extremely yeehaw, because that was the only thing I could do to slightly give the indication of this ever being a horse. The one thing I knew I wanted to do was I wanted to make these characters have half-shaved heads. And that's because that's how horses' manes grow. All their hair falls over to one side of their heads. So I knew I wanted that in the design, but other than that, I was stuck. I changed the color palette to be this brown color palette because the horse Kwame is apparently a paint horse. So I looked at different pictures of paint horses, and again, the black and white palette was giving cow. not horse. So I switched it to a brown and white palette, and I think that worked somewhat better. Some of you guys really liked this design when I posted it on TikTok, but I'm not really a fan of it. I hate the Western vibe. This is genuinely the only thing I could come up with, and it makes me so upset that I couldn't come up with anything else. I just could not come up with anything that looked good, and I still don't like it to this day. Oh, also, I changed the Miraculous. It's no longer glasses. I hate the Miraculous being glasses because glasses didn't exist when the Miraculouses were made. It doesn't make sense. So I couldn't figure out what to switch it to either, so I made it be a bandana. We could definitely change it to something else. I'm open to ideas, just not glasses because that doesn't make any sense. But this is what I came up with. There would be a jacket that would have the horse symbol on the back, because I really like that horse symbol, but that was like the only thing I could come up with. It's very yeehaw. I don't know how to feel about it. I don't feel great about it, but I couldn't come up with anything else, and I haven't seen anyone else do anything that's good with this concept. So to me, the horse is a lost cause, and honestly, I'm okay with that. I don't like the horse.
We all want a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle, but which one could turn you into Squirtle?
Okay, so the challenge with making the turtle designs is that I really like the Jade Turtle design, Master Fu's Jade Turtle design, so I needed to do something entirely different that still solved the issues that I have with Nino's design. To me, Nino's design is just too slender, it's too skinny, it's a turtle. Come on, guys, it's a turtle. Turtles are not slender, they are not slim, they are not skinny, they are bulky lads. So something that I played around with in this one was making the general form of these characters be more bulky, so the more feminine character has a very floofy ponytail that's very curly, she has very thick, bulky boots, and a little puffer jacket that would be waterproof, so it would dry off quickly if she got in the water, and then I gave her some shoulder pads, or a hexagon shape matching the look of the bracelet that they wear, that's the Miraculous, and I gave her some chest armor as well, some gloves, some armored boots, and then I gave her a little bandana, a little hair tie, because I thought that would be a cute little touch. And then the guy, sort of like Master Fu, has really poofy pants and a really nice strong armored chest plate. Again, we have that same hexagon shape going on, we have those shoulder pads, we have some nice gloves, and we have some really padded boots. I think this really solves the problem by adding a lot more bulk while still keeping it really fun, but it doesn't feel oversaturated. I did desaturate the color palette a bit just so it doesn't feel too overwhelming. And then I drew these guys in action, and I think these guys are really, really strong when you see them moving around. I think they look really good. They look really strong. They look like really capable fighters. These look like real things I could see in combat, so I think I did a really good job with these ones, especially with the color distribution, because working with this many greens can be difficult at times.
Rats! We're rats! We're the rats! We pray at night, we stalk at night, we're the rats!
I think the mouse may be the singular Miraculous that has had more than one bearer, that has had it look good both times. Both Milan and Marinette's designs for the mouse are great, they look really good, so I definitely wanted to do something different that neither of these designs had done before, and I actually did some sketching beforehand that I really liked with these, so I had two different ideas, same sort of vibe. I wanted these to be very bouncy, something that you could really see these guys running around in and doing a lot of active stuff in, because my idea for this is I would slightly change around the rabbit, and thus I would have to change around the mouse. The mouse would just have the ability to grow and shrink, kind of like Ant-Man does. There's a lot you can do with that. It doesn't have to be able to multiply. That was the idea. I really wanted to tie the jump rope around the waist, sort of like Milan has with her poly mouse design, because I think that's very cute, a nice way to carry it around. It's efficient, so that's definitely what I wanted to do. I kept Marinette's two bun look, because that's a great way to do mouse ears without literally making a hood, which I did do on the guy, because it is a cute design, but I played around with a different idea. I gave her overalls as a form of jumpsuit, because we haven't really seen any jumpsuit designs in the show, so I thought that would be fun to play with. I also used the little logo design for the mouse quite a bit throughout it, because that is a really cute design. Like, I want to see that in there. And then for the guy design, I decided to give him a jogger outfit, a tracksuit outfit, somewhat inspired by Yato's outfit in Noragami, because he has a tracksuit, and I definitely wanted to go for that kind of vibe. It's very active, easy to run around in, something that could easily grow and shrink in. So that was the vibe I was going for. I had a very fun time with this one. It's a great color palette. It's so nice and soothing. I really liked playing around with such a bouncy type of character. It was really fun. I like this one.
Number 5! This mighty spirit is infectious! Rabbit Hero, here go!
So for the rabbit, the original concept is time travel, and I really hate that the rabbit is time travel. I don't like when time travel is randomly inserted into shows that didn't previously have time travel in it and doesn't have anything to do with time travel as a plot point, or at least not as a major plot point. So I decided I would completely change around what the rabbit can do, which is why I mentioned the mouse earlier would just be shrinking and growing, because I would give the rabbit the ability to multiply instead. The rabbit would also be really good at jumping, and they would be able to use thumping on the ground to be able to sense where their multiples are at, because that's how rabbits communicate in real life. Rabbits are also surprisingly strong creatures, so I really wanted to make sure that these guys were really, really strong and muscular. I wanted these guys to be very formidable and intimidating, because usually rabbits really aren't perceived to be that strong, but they are. They are insanely strong. They're very fast, they're very good jumpers, they're very, very good at hiding. Rabbits are very intelligent creatures. And I really wanted to make that clear in this design. I did use the original color palette that Alex has in her design, because that is the Kwame's colors, but essentially everything else is completely different. You can see this is where I started going back to using theatrical masks, because I made one of the bunnies have this more theatrical style bunny mask, which I thought was a very interesting and unique little play on this idea. And then I used the idea of the hood to give the guy bunny ears as a hood with this jacket look, because I thought that would be interesting and fun to play around with. I think these ones are pretty cool, and they definitely match more superhero vibes than what I've done originally. They aren't too traditional, they don't look too fantasy-esque. I think these ones did a pretty good job at capturing the modern superhero vibe better than most of them.
You may wind up with one of, maybe the son of that darn cat.
Switching back to a more traditional vibe, the cat doesn't have too many dramatic changes from what already exists. I think the cat noir design is pretty solid. Kitty noir, not great. I'm forgetting the name of Marinette's cat design at the moment, but that one's just meh to me. So my idea with the cats was again to use more theatrical masks, so I have a really theatrical looking cat mask going on, and essentially I wanted a more traditional vibe with this one, so a lot more layers going on, heavily inspired by the Anbu Black Ops outfits that we see in Naruto, the ones that Kakashi wear, and other Naruto style outfits. I thickened the tail a bit, because originally the tail is just a belt, and while I think that's very creative and cool, I wanted to do something different, so I have a more sash style look that has a ring on the bottom. It could attached to things, who knows. I also use the green as more of an accent color throughout my versions of the designs, because right now the green really only exists in the eyes of the different cats. And with the paw being such a cute little design element, it's something I really wanted to include, so I decided to add in green as a very soft accent color. I feel like these ones flow and move really well. They feel very fluid. I really, really like the way that the tail looks as it's moving. These feel very sleek and very elegant, yet they feel easy to move around in, so I think I did a pretty good job with these. The lack of color also helped with this one, because if this was not a black and green color palette, I definitely think I would have had a more difficult time, but black is a solid color to work with, so I think this was a pretty easy one to do. So I knew the bees were going to be an interesting challenge, because there's never been a male bee Miraculous holder, at least not yet, and I'm pretty sure the reason for that is because the only male bees that exist are drone bees, and I really didn't want to do drones as my guy bee. That would just not work at all. Don't even want to approach that, no thank you. So I just completely ignored that idea entirely. And my idea for the guy bee actually turned out to be a worker bee. I know worker bees are female, I know that, but frankly, I don't care, I'm not doing a drone. So my male bee would be a quote-unquote worker bee. My girl version of the bee is very elegant. Again, I wanted to give my bug-themed characters wings if those bugs have the ability to fly. So my female bee does have the ability to fly. She has this scarf that essentially has this ombre look that starts yellow and then fades into the color of the wings. She also has more of a jumpsuit vibe going on with some nice puffy pants that would be really lightweight and some nice shoes. I also thought it would be interesting to play around with characters that have short hair, characters that can't wear the comb in their hair because the Miraculous is a comb. Not everyone can wear a comb in their hair, so I wanted to figure out what I would do in the case of a character who doesn't have hair that's long enough or thick enough to put a comb in. So for the more feminine one, it's attaching to the scarf. The one for the guy would have that comb be inside the pocket on the jacket. And now that I'm actually drawing the guy, you can see more of the worker vibe that I was going for. Some really heavy duty cargo pants, a really, really thick jacket that would be really well suited for heavy duty work, some nice tactical wings that they could fly around real fast with, some knee pads. This one is just very ready for action. I also played around with the idea of antenna, so both of these characters have little bits of hair sticking up at the top to indicate the look of antenna, because usually when we see the bees, they have some sort of hair tie that looks like antenna. But again, we're doing short-haired characters here, so that's not really a possibility. I also played around with some smaller shapes for the stripes, because I didn't want the black to feel overwhelming with these designs, and then I also made the color palette be more gold, because originally the color palette for the bee is very bright yellow and it's a little bit on the greenish side, and I didn't really want to use that. I wanted a nice soft gold color, so I decided to reference that instead. Overall, I think these look really good and I'm very happy with how they ended up looking. I think that I balanced out the yellow and the black really well. Yellow and black is one of my favorite color palettes to work with, so this was very much in my comfort zone and very, very fun to do. I had a great time with it and I think these look pretty good. I really like both of them, so let me know what you think of these.
What you know about rolling down in the deep when your brain goes numb, you can call that mental free.
Now for the bowl, what I really wanted to go with for the bowl, ox, whatever you would like to consider this, I'm just going to keep calling it the bowl for now. I really wanted to go for a military combat jacket style look. I really wanted these guys to look very heavily armored and strong. They would be in a similar vein as the goat. They'd be a frontal assault type. However, the bull has a hammer. The bull seems to always have some sort of hammer that they use, so I really wanted to include a custom hammer design in here, but something that referenced the shapes of the design a little bit better. I wanted to include the spike imagery that you see me including on these designs, so I essentially completely redesigned the hammer to look like one of my reference photos, just matching it with the colors of the bull's color palette, and I made some action poses of them swinging around this big hammer. Both of these figures would have really, really armored outfits. One of them has this more combat style jacket, the other one has a poncho, and they're both meant to hide these huge chest plates that they have on that are very durable and really heavily armored. They have some nice combat grade boots, some nice pants. Overall, just very strong and armored characters. I want these guys to feel pretty intimidating, which is why I went for a darker color palette. I want you to see these guys and feel threatened. I also felt it was important to leave the gold as just an accent color because too much gold can become really overpowering really quickly, so I kept it very, very subtle. It was fun to design a hammer. I don't usually design tools, but this one was fun to play around with. And yes, I do acknowledge that some of these poses are anatomically impossible because of the horns. So, my bad there, I did not realize that. But overall, I feel like these are pretty solid. They're definitely better than what we got in this show, so let me know what you think. So I was infamously unaware that Kim's monkey design is literally just supposed to be Sun Wukong from Journey to the West. Thank you all for telling me that in my original video where I broke down his design. I still don't care. I really don't care. I read a summary of Journey to the West, I looked up who Sun Wukong was, and honestly, I'm in the same boat as I am for the bunny here. I don't care that it's based off of Sun Wukong. I don't care that the rabbit is based off of Alice in Wonderland. In my opinion, these designs should be able to exist on their own without being entirely referential to something else. Essentially, Kim's design is nothing but a reference to Sun Wukong, and it's intended to reference it to a T. And I think these designs should be able to stand on their own as their own unique things without relying on other things and other source material as their main source of inspiration. So I completely ignored that. I did not use any Journey to the West stuff or any Sun Wukong stuff when I was making these designs for the monkeys. I wanted to do something that was very fun and bouncy using the colors of the monkey Miraculous and relying on more round and softer shapes. So I have this very bouncy, very puffy outfit for the more feminine one. The one thing I did keep was the rope tail in Kim's design because I think that is a very nice little design element that I think is very fun and I really like it. But overall, I just wanted these to be very bouncy and fun and feel like something very safe and protective. So I have more rounded edges rather than sharp ones. The guy one has a lot more armor to him, but they would all have this really nice reinforced leather. That's what I expect this darker brown color to be. Overall, I think I did a very good job with what little I was given. I definitely prefer this jumpsuit vibe. I really like the armor vibe. I think it's so much better than what we have in the show. Again, I don't care about the Journey to the West references. I just don't. I think they should be their own unique things. So that's exactly what I did with mine.
If you see us in the club, we'll be acting real nice. If you see us on the floor, you'll be watching all night.
So the tiger was an interesting challenge for me, first off because of the color palette. This is a color palette that I really am not a fan of. Obviously, there are no pink tigers, and I feel like this color palette is just really oversaturated. It's not a palette I enjoy working with. I really had a challenge with this one, but I think I made the best of it in my two designs that I made. I also had two completely different visions for where I could go with this. I thought I could reference the more punk look that Julika's design originally has, or I could go with a more traditional look. So I decided to do both because I couldn't make a choice between the two. They both use the same color palette, however I decided to emphasize a lot more of the black in their designs because this is a lot of pink. It's a very, very vibrant pink, and I thought, okay, well the only way to really tone this down is to add more black. So that's what I did. I made black a lot more prevalent in both of these designs. The punk one has a lot more imagery to the spikes. I was hoping I could tie that into the stripes that I have throughout the design. I also used the gold as an accent color again just because I didn't want it to become too overwhelming and I wanted it to match the look of the Miraculous. Then for the guy, I wanted to go for a more traditional samurai style look or swordsman style look, which is why Zoro is on here as inspiration. Again, I used a more theatrical mask look of this tiger mask and I really wanted these characters to be very strong and muscular. So again, very strong looking characters. I really hope that these guys look intimidating to you because that's definitely the perception I have of tigers. They're definitely very intimidating. So I'm hoping by using spikes and bulkier shapes that this gets the point across. For working with a color palette that I'm not a fan of, I think I did a really, really good job with these. Sort of like with the horse, I had to take a total overhaul of this one, though I did stick with the original color palette. My idea for the pig was entirely different from what we see in the show. I don't really think a lot of time or effort was put into the development of the pig Miraculous. It seems just like another cheaper version of the Ladybug Miraculous to me. It seems to me like they were running out of ideas and weren't sure what to do, so I decided to just do my own thing with it. Now, from what I understand, the pig Miraculous stands for joy and jollity and happiness and festivity. It's supposed to be very joyful from what I understand. So playing along with that, I started thinking about what I could possibly use a tambourine for, what I could possibly use the pig imagery for, and how I could include joyfulness and festivity into this. So essentially my idea is whoever is wearing this Miraculous would have a outfit that is similar to the traditional style of folk dance from whatever country or culture they may come from. There's a lot of different types of folk dancing out there, and all of them have different styles of outfits, different styles of dance, and different poses, different methods of dance. They're all very beautiful, and there were so many that I was inspired to explore, but I decided to just use Roma and Romani culture for this one because I felt that there was a lot of really pretty outfits I could take inspiration from and come up with something really fun and unique for this outfit. So I played a lot with headbands and bandanas and a lot of really pretty layered clothing. I wanted this to feel very joyful and carefree and festive, so that's what I was going for with these designs. I also figured they would have shorter hair so that way their hair is kept out of the way as they're performing or dancing. I would also change the tambourine to do something else. The power would do something else. It wouldn't be the surprise tool to help you later. It wouldn't be looking into your heart's greatest desires or whatever. It wouldn't be doing that. I also decided to use a texture brush to include a little bit of a splotchy look because I really like the look of spotted pigs, so I did play around with that in the design as well. I also didn't realize at the time that the little Miraculous thing is an anklet. I thought it was a bracelet, so I put it on the wrong spot. That was my bad. I didn't realize that it was not a bracelet, but instead an anklet. And I also didn't realize that the little things on the bracelet or anklet are supposed to be pearls. I thought they were bells. So across this design, everybody has bells. There's bells all over it. And my intention was to hopefully confuse someone into not knowing where the Miraculous actually is because there's so many bells. I'm not sure if this is the correct direction to go with the pig because it doesn't really read as superhero to me, so let me know what you think of what I did with this. So the dog had a very unique challenge to it, and that's that it has the exact same color palette as the fox. And something that I saw in my video where I broke down all of the Miraculous designs, a lot of people commented that they honestly felt that if they hadn't realized that Felix was a dog, or if they hadn't been told that he was a dog, that they would have thought that he was the fox at first glance, because the shape language and the colors are so similar to the fox Miraculous. Now, I see that as a huge problem, because that means that we have to work really hard to make sure that these two are very distinct from each other.
dog and fox, they're both canines, yeah, sure. But they're completely different. They have completely different powers. I feel like they should have completely different aesthetics and vibes. So in order to make sure that I made the dogs absolutely stand out and apart from the fox, I wanted to make sure that I had a completely different aesthetic going on. So for the dogs, I went with this very muscular outdoorsy style aesthetic that's specifically similar to hunting gear and tracking gear, because I figured I would change the dog's powers. I don't like the fetch power. It just works like a pokeball to me. So what I did was I decided to change the power of the dog to be a tracking power. Essentially, they would use these bones that you see across the bells, as well as tied to the pants, that they would use to then magically attach to any character or any villain that they're trying to chase down. If they're trying to catch someone and they run away, they'd be able to track them using those bones, their sense of smell, natural dog senses. That's something that I felt was really lacking in the dog Miraculous, was that they weren't actually using any of the natural abilities that dogs have to a superpowered advantage. And to me, that seemed like an obvious thing to do, so I decided to do it. Another thing that I really wanted to change was that the dog, as you can see, the dog Kwame looks like a beagle. It's supposed to be a beagle of some kind, I'm pretty sure, and I really didn't want to use a beagle as my reference, especially with how awful Sabrina's design looks. So I decided I wanted to use more hunting dogs as my reference, so I used the style of German pointers for the patterning. I also used the Basenji, which is a really good hunting dog. I also used the Brittany, which is another sort of retriever, which is very good at hunting and retrieving. I also used Great Pyrenees as my inspiration, because those are very heavy-duty dogs. They're really tolerable to weather. So would these guys. These guys would be great in the weather. They'd be great outdoors. They'd be great hunters, great trackers. Essentially, that is the whole vibe of these guys. While the fox is more mysterious, they're a bit more attuned to the nightlife. They like to slink around in the shadows. They're a lot more tricksy. You don't exactly know what's going on with them. Dog is going to be way more outgoing, way more extroverted. It's going to be way louder. It's going to be a lot more up in your face. So I think with those two vibes taken into account, I think that you can come out of this seeing just how different I ended up making the fox and the dog be. So now we don't have that confusion anymore.
Second to last, I did the dragon, and this one I had a lot more traditional ideas for. I wanted to go for a more traditional swordsman style look while still being very heavily inspired by the Fire Nation from Avatar The Last Airbender, along with using various elements of dragon inspired armor. Those were the vibes that I was going for here, along with an emphasis on the look of a dragon's tail. I thought that was something that was included really well inside Kagami's Ryuko design, and I quite like Kagami's Ryuko design. I think it looks pretty good. So I ended up using that quite a lot in my own take on these designs. I stuck with just a regular, very basic color palette of red, gold, and black. I put a lot more emphasis on the dark red than we saw in Kagami's Ryuko design. I felt like that was a pretty prominent color in the Kwame's design, so I definitely wanted to keep that in my version of this design. I also wanted to give off imagery of dragon tails or wings, so both of these designs have a slight element of having wings or a tail to them. So this one that you see here, of the more masculine one, has these two little pieces of fabric at the back that hang down and sort of move like a dragon's tail would. Similarly, the female also has a similar look going on. She has a piece of fabric that hangs down from her waist that looks very similar to a dragon's tail, and that's the vibe I was going for there. Another thing you'll notice with both of these is that they have this very interesting looking helmet that's inspired by the shape of the Kwame's head. The Kwame has this really cool spiky head that has these little stripes on it, and then these little dark red spikes or horns on top. I thought it was a really cool look, and I wanted to see if I could turn it into a helmet in any sort of way. So that was fun to play around with, and I think I came up with something I really like. The only thing I'm not quite a fan of on this is the way that I posed the guy originally. It's just a very awkward pose and doesn't really make sense. But I did fix that when I did the action pose, so it still looks good. And another thing that I added was the texture of scales. I don't think I would use scale mail with this. Scale mail is cool, but it's very hard to move around in and it's very noisy. So I would rather just have fabric that has a dragon scale printed onto it rather than actual scale mail. I think it works pretty well for this particular design. I think the colors are balanced pretty evenly. I think I was still able to incorporate the dragon imagery into this real nicely and still have it feel very traditional and strong.
This one's for Bad Boy Halo!
Last but not least, we have the rooster, and the reason I saved the rooster for last was because, unfortunately, I really, really like the redesigns for the rooster. And essentially, when I took some time to look at the redesigns for the rooster that others have made, I realized that they had already made exactly what I would make. All of the rooster redesigns that you see here on the mood board are what I would have made. And the only thing I could think of doing that hadn't been done yet was that it's a rooster Miraculous, but there aren't female roosters. They're just chickens. So I figured if a female were to have this Miraculous, they would be a chicken, not a rooster. And that's something that hasn't really been explored before. And that was definitely fun because I got to look at all the different types of colors of chickens. And my god, there are so many different colors of chickens and types of chickens. I just went with a color palette of a standard black, gray, and red chicken because I thought those colors worked nicely together. I still use the style of boots that you see in a lot of the redesigns, similar to how Mark's original design looks as well. The only vibe that I really had in mind when I went into this was musketeer vibes. Going back to the peacock at the very beginning of this video, I wanted to go for musketeer vibes, or at least something similar to that, so I looked at a lot of musketeer fashion because I felt this should be very theatrical and over the top in a little bit of a way, because that's how chickens are. And then for the guy, I was also still kind of out of ideas because most of the design ideas I had in mind had already been done before. So I stuck with that musketeer vibe again. I gave it slightly different colors, somewhat using the main color palette of the rooster, but just trying to do something different than already exists. These are definitely not the best of the series. I would like to end this on a high note, but I really just don't think that this was my best work, especially considering that everything that I would have done originally already exists. So shout out to the redesigners out there, my fellow designers, because you guys did a great job. You guys beat me. You beat me to what I would have done. So anyway, that is what the final rooster designs ended up looking like. So here it is. Here are all of the designs that I made for redesigning every single Miraculous hero of Miraculous Ladybug, taking my own spin on the Miraculous, what they could look like, the possibilities of these outfits, and I had fun with it. Despite all of the struggles that I went through, and despite how long it took me to make this series, I enjoyed it. I had fun with it. And I hope you all enjoyed it too. As always, you can leave whatever feedback you would like on these because, you know, I've said before, I don't feel super strong about all of these. Some of these I think I did really well on. Some of these definitely need improvement. Some of these I just didn't really have the inspiration to do it at all. And I think it definitely shows. So let me know what you think of these. Again, disclaimer, I don't like this show. Not a fan of this show. But hey, I enjoyed the series and I hope other people do too. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you feel so inclined so you can see more videos like this and more art videos that I'm going to be putting out in the future. That is all for now, and I'll see you all in my next video.